All eyes on Alabama, the state's critical special election, just hours from the finish line. GOP Senate candidate Roy Moore setting the record straight one last time as his opponent launches some brand new attacks. Griff Jenkins live in our nation's capital with what is at stake? And there's a whole lot at stake, right, Griff?
That's right. Good morning, Heather. We're coming down to the wire. Alabama voters going to the polls tomorrow. But this morning, they're waking up to a robocall from President Trump, a final push for the embattled Republican Roy Moore.
Get out and vote for Roy Moore. His vote is our Republican Senate, and it's needed. We need Roy to help us with the Republican Senate. We will win, and we will make America great again.
Moore, who has been running as an outsider, was noticeably absent from the campaign trail this weekend and avoiding reporters, but called into a radio show to again defiantly deny all allegations of sexual misconduct against him and attack the Republican establishment, who has refused to support him.
The Republican establishment actually wants Jones in there because they think they can beat him in 2 years without a contest. And, of course, the Democrats want Jones in there for their vote.
Meanwhile, Doug Jones barnstormed the state with a last-minute push from establishment Democrats like New Jersey Senator Cory Booker, who flew in to join him on the campaign trail. Jones took a shot at Moore, accusing him of not being accessible to the voters.
What kind of public servant hides and goes only into enclaves and doesn't address the media? I'm going to be as accessible after this election as I am now.
Jones also received some support on Twitter from Hollywood stars like Mark Ruffalo and Patton Oswalt, but Moore maintains a slight lead in the polls and plans to close out his campaign tonight with a large rally, Heather, featuring, among others, Steve Bannon. We'll see what happens.
All right. Thank you so much, Griff Jenkins, live for us this morning. We appreciate it.